Hi, my name is Sarah Highfield and welcome to my restorative yoga class. I'm going to be using a bolster today for this class. Any good restorative yoga class will be using bolsters, but if you don't have one of these in your house, you can substitute with maybe a pillow from your bed or some cushions from your sofa or even a folded up blanket. So I'll give everyone a few moments now to collect anything that they need. In the meantime, I just want to let you know that this class is suitable for all levels and it's a very relaxing class. It's not the kind of class where you're going to be breaking out in sweat. Hopefully, it will leave you feeling very calm and refreshed. So I hope you have your bolsters or something you can use as a bolster. And the first pose that we'll be doing is child's pose. So let me demonstrate how we do it with the bolster. For your child's pose, you may want to take your knees wide and keep the feet together. Your other option is to keep the knees together and the feet together. Play around with both of them and see what works for you. You can then take your bolster, place it lengthways on your mat, and then slowly lower your chest down onto the bolster and bring your forehead down. Stay like this and relax. As you're relaxing here, allow the upper body to feel heavy and really allow the body to ground down towards the mat. You should feel a gentle stretch through the back of the body. And this is a really nice way to start the class by bringing the mind and the body down to the mat and to stillness. So, stay like this. Keep breathing deeply in and out of your nose and try to relax. We'll take a few more breaths here. And then to come out of it, inhale, push yourself up and walk your hands in. Come to sitting on your bum and extend both of your legs out in front of you. Now, for this pose, we'll come into a forward fold using the bolster. The bolster can either be placed under the legs like this, and you're going to relax the body down, or on top of the legs like this. You can rest the arms on the bolster. I'm going to do it like this. I personally find this more comfortable, but again, have a play around. Place the bolster under the legs, see how it feels. Place it over the legs. And then when you've decided what you're going to do, move the fleshy parts from under your bum. Inhale, lengthen the spine, and exhale, fold forward. Now, if you want, you can hold on to the toes or hold on to the ankles. This is not a normal forward fold that you would do in, say, an Ashtanga class. This is not Paschimottanasana. This is a relaxed forward fold. So if the back does bend a little bit, that's fine. We're not aiming for the straight spine that is often asked for in yoga. This is simply so you can relax forward and stretch through the backs of the legs and the back of the body. So once you've found a point in the pose which is comfortable, try to allow the upper body to feel heavy and see if each time you exhale, you can fold a little bit further forward. Again, don't worry too much about getting the straight spine. So long as you can feel the stretch through the backs of the legs and through the back of the body, you're doing this correctly. Keep breathing deeply in and out of the nose. And what you should find is that the first few breaths in this pose, they can be a little bit uncomfortable, as in your body is stretching and you can feel that stretch. But the longer you stay like this, the longer you stay relaxing in the pose, the more comfortable you should feel. I personally, when I do this, the first sort of few breaths are a little bit uncomfortable, but then after that, it's like that discomfort just disappears, and I actually really find it relaxing. So I hope you are too. We'll stay like this for a few more breaths. And then inhale to come back up. Now we'll come into a variation of Janushirasana using the bolster again. So keep your right leg extended out in front of you and bring your left foot onto the inner right thigh. Your options here are to place the bolster under the leg or over the leg. Again, I'm going to demonstrate it with over the leg. I find it more comfortable. Move the bum. And then inhale to lengthen, exhale, relax forward. So either hold on to your foot or the ankle, or just rest your arms on the bolster. Whatever feels good for you here. If you can, keep the foot flexed. That's going to give you a little bit of a deeper stretch. But don't worry if you just want to kind of relax the foot. You're still going to get a stretch. Again, let the body come down towards the bolster or the leg with every exhalation. So when you inhale, feel your body expand. When you exhale, try to relax down. Make sure you can feel the stretch through the back of the leg. And you're stretching enough to feel it, but not so much that you're straining or you're on the verge of injury. That is not what yoga is about. This class in particular is about relaxing. This is restorative yoga. So it's not about pushing yourself beyond what's comfortable or safe. Let's stay here for two more deep breaths. And then inhale, come up and swap your legs over. Extend the left leg out, bring your right foot on the left inner thigh, place the bolster either under the leg or above. Move the fleshy parts from under your bum. This will help you to fold forward. And then inhale to lengthen the spine, exhale, relax forward. Again, feel that gentle stretch through the back of the leg. And let the upper body feel heavy as it relaxes down towards the bolster of the leg. Really try to feel any sensations within the body as you do this. So try to practice with awareness and sensitivity towards yourself. Let's take two more deep breaths here. And slowly inhale to come up. Okay, place your bolster to one side, give your legs a little shake, and then bring the soles of the feet together. Now, don't draw the feet all the way in like this. Keep them kind of out in front of you like this. Move the fleshy parts from under the bum, and then take your bolster, or your cushions or your pillow, and place it lengthways, resting on your feet like this. From here, inhale to lengthen, exhale, relax, forward.
You can bring the forehead down onto the bolster or the back of the hands.
Maybe you're a little bit higher up, you can rest the arms on the bolster. Do whatever feels good here. Find your comfortable spot. Try to breathe deeply in and out of the nose. And the more you can relax here, the deeper you will stretch. Take a few more deep breaths like this. And then inhale, push yourself up, and you can move your bolster to one side. Now I'm going to turn sideways on my mat, just so I can demonstrate this a little bit better. From here, extend both your legs out either side of you, like this. Move the fleshy parts from under the bum, and then take your bolster and place it in front of you lengthways. We're coming into a wide leg forward fold. If you can, keep your feet flexed. If they soften, that's also fine. But obviously with the flexed feet, you get a little bit of a deeper stretch. Remember, you should move the fleshy parts from under the bum because that's really gonna help you with the forward fold here. Now, inhale to lengthen the spine and exhale, relax down. So walk your hands forward. Maybe you rest the arms down like this. Maybe the forehead comes down like this. So work with your body, listen to your body and see how you feel. The most important thing here, it's not about getting a deep stretch, it's about relaxing with a mild stretch. So keep breathing deeply in and out of the nose. And every time you inhale, feel your body expand. Every time you exhale, fold deeper. The fold here comes from the hips. The spine will round naturally, but if you can keep it a little bit longer, that will give you a better stretch. Maybe see if you can walk your hands forward a little bit more or come down a little bit further. So keep pushing yourself gently. By now, the stretch in the legs shouldn't be so intense. The longer you hold the stretch, it should get a little bit more comfortable. So that does give you space to move a little bit deeper into the Let's take two more deep breaths here. And then inhale, push yourself up and walk the hands in. Okay, we're gonna come into pigeon pose using the bolster. So pigeon pose is a hip opener. Place your bolster to one side, and I'm going to turn sideways on my mat again. You can have your right leg forward like this and your left leg back. Now, before we come into this pose, if you want a deeper stretch, you would bring the right leg up the mat like this so that the shin lines up with the top of the mat. But don't worry about having a really deep stretch. If that's a little bit too much for you, keep your leg down like this. And then take your bolster. You can place it out either lengthways or across the top of your mat. Make sure that your hips are square to the front of the mat. Have a quick look at the leg behind you. Make sure it's going in a straight line. Sometimes the leg can go off to the side without you realizing. And then inhale, lengthen. Exhale, lower yourself down onto your bolster.
Again, you can rest the forehead down onto the backs of the hands,
or maybe just rest the forearms down. See what feels good. Make sure you can feel the deep stretch through the front of your left hip and the stretch through the right glute. Try to relax here, allowing the body to feel heavy. Remember, the more you can relax, the deeper you will stretch.
Really feel the spine long here.
And if you can, try to ensure that the weight is running through the center of the body, so you're not collapsing to your left or your right.
Couple more breaths.
Okay, inhale, push yourself up and walk your hands in. Let's swap the legs over. So tuck under the back toes and push up and swap the legs. Now, again, if you want to lift up the leg a little bit higher on the mat for a deeper stretch, then do so. Look back at the leg behind you. Make sure it's going in a straight line. Hands either side of you. Inhale to lengthen the spine. Exhale, relax down onto your bolster. Stay like this. Allow the body to feel heavy and relax. So this is pigeon pose using the bolster. It's a really nice way to do the pose. I mean, it's kind of a relaxing pose anyway. It's definitely not the hardest, but the bolster makes it so relaxing. I mean, I have some students who literally could sleep in this pose. I mean, I think one of them did tell me they kind of do sleep like this. So with the bolster, it's super, super relaxing. And it's a great stretch for the glute and the hip. So let's take a few more breaths here. Okay, inhale, push yourself up and swing that back leg forward. And now we're going to come into a side stretch using the bolster. So, have your bolster across your mat like this and sit side on. From here, lower yourself down. You can bring the arm out. And with your top arm, you can either bring it in front of you or you can also bring it up. You want to feel the stretch through the side of your body. Now, don't worry which side you're lying on. We're going to do both sides. So, allow yourself to relax, and remember, the more you relax here, the deeper you can stretch. This is, aside from Shavasana, probably one of the easiest yoga poses you can do. But it's very effective. I mean, if you're using a pillow, for example, or you're using quite a small bolster like I am, the stretch isn't as deep. But obviously, if you stick another cushion under there, you really get a nice deep side stretch. And you don't have to do any work. You just lie down. It's a passive stretch. Gravity does all the work for you. So these kind of stretches are the best ones. I mean, they're incredibly relaxing because you don't need to use any energy. So, a couple more breaths here. and then inhale, push yourself up, and we swap sides. So, move the bolster to the other side of you, and then relax down. Remember, with the arms, they can both be up like this, or you can have one arm down in front of you, wherever is comfortable. So try to relax here, feel a stretch through the side of the body. Remember, if you need maybe an extra cushion just for a deeper stretch, feel free to use one. So let's take two more deep breaths. And then inhale, push yourself up. And we're going to come into bridge pose on your bolster. So keep the bolster just behind you. This time, you can place your bum on the bolster and come back. So, this is bridge pose using the bolster. This is super relaxing. Again, I'm using a very small bolster. If you need to stick another cushion under there, you can lift your bum up and place one under so you get a little bit more height. But just relax here. This is a very gentle, gentle lift in the hips. And what you should feel is the body really pressing down to the floor, really relaxing. So let's stay here for a few deep breaths. Take one more deep breath here. And then straighten your legs. So keep the bum on the bolster, straighten your legs, and feel the stretch in the front of the hips. This is really nice to do if you've been sitting all day, or in fact, anytime, not just us sitting, but we are often in flexion, so the body is often sort of folding forward. So whether you're sitting, whether you're driving, when you're eating your meals. So what this does is it puts the body into extension. So you're in a gentle back bend and it stretches the front of the hips, stretches the front of the body. And it's really nice because it counteracts all of the forward folding that we naturally do throughout the day. As you're lying here, obviously make sure there's no pain or discomfort in the back. And take a few more deep breaths. Now, slowly push yourself up. And put your bum back on the floor in front of your cushions or bolster. You can extend the legs out straight and then lower back down. So we're in a supported back bend with your arms happen alongside you, or maybe extend them back wherever is comfortable for you. So you really want to feel the stretch, not in the hips this time, but through the front of the stomach. Relax here. And again, make sure there's no discomfort in the back. If you need a deeper back bend, you can always place another cushion under you. Or if it's too much for you, you know, take the cushion away and place something smaller. Even a folded up jumper will give you a gentle back bend. Remember, the more you can relax, the deeper you'll stretch. Take two more deep breaths here. Slowly inhale and push yourself up. We will come into a supportive twist. So, place the bolster lengthways on the mat behind you. You can have your knees pointing one way and then bring the front of your body down onto your bolster and either bring the forehead down onto the back of the hands or turn the head away from the knees for a deeper stretch. So this is a supported twist. As you're relaxing here, try to ensure that the spine is long. And as always, make sure that you're comfortable. Take a couple more deep breaths. And then swap sides. Push yourself up, swap the legs over, and bring the front of the body down. Bring the forehead down on top of your hands, or turn the head away from the knees. Make sure that the spine is long and that the body is relaxed. Take two more deep breaths. And then inhale, push yourself up. And now keep the bolster where it is. We're going to come into Supta Baddha Konasana. So this is going to be your final pose. And this is what we're going to use for your Shavasana. So, bring the soles of your feet together and let the knees drop out to the sides. With your bolster or cushions behind you, slowly lower yourself down. Take your time, lower down. Once you're down, make sure that you're comfortable. You can have your arms alongside the body, maybe with the palms up. And now, relax here. This is the final pose, and what we're doing here is we're allowing the knees to drop down towards the floor so that the hips are open, and we're opening up through the front of the chest. So let the shoulders drop down either side of your cushions or bolster. The head is supported, and then close your eyes and let your breath flow naturally. Let your body feel heavy and just enjoy this stretch. Enjoy the final moments of the yoga class. Every time you exhale, feel the body sinking down deeper into the mat. Feel the body, the muscles softening. Just allow your mind to be clear. keeping your eyes closed, start to move your fingers and your toes. Gently turn your head side to side. And then you can stretch your legs out. Stretch your arms up, stretch the body long. And keep your eyes closed. Very slowly make your way back up to seated. Take your time. Come up to a comfortable seated position. Grounding down through the sit bones, lengthening the spine, and keeping the shoulders soft. Take a moment to notice how your body feels and notice how your mind feels. Have a little moment of gratitude towards yourself for doing yoga today. And then place your hands in your heart center in prayer position. Bow your head and say namaste. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed the class and that you're feeling very relaxed and restored. Have a lovely day, and hopefully I will see you all soon.